left in church on Sunday morning. Grandma's hand played a tambourine so well. Grandma's hand used to issue out a warning. She'd say, Billy, don't you run so fast. Might fall on a piece of glass. Might be snakes there.
Happy birthday, grandmother. This is Alton, your oldest grandson. One of the fondest moments I have with you is making sure that we went to church. I remember Vacation Bible School and learning so much about something that I would use even today. And so that's your largest contribution to my life that I can remember. One of the best things that I appreciate about you is how strong you are. You're so much stronger than the rest of us, and you've gotten us through some tough times, and I'm just glad that you could spend your 85th birthday looking at this video. I love you, and I will be there to see you probably before the end of the year. So until then, have a wonderful day.
You wanna spank him for? He didn't drop no apple core, but I don't have grandma anymore. If I get to heaven, I'll look for grandma's hand.
What's your name?
Amari.
How old are you?
Four.
Okay, fat man, what's your name? Move, I can't see you. Come over here.
Fat man.
How old are you?
PJ, I'm 11.
All right, what y'all want to tell grandma?
Happy birthday.
All right, y'all ready?
I'm Takira, I'm Alton's daughter, and those are my three boys. Love you, bye.
Used to issue out a warning, she'd say, Billy, don't you run so fast. Might fall on a piece of glass. Might be snakes there in that grass, grandma's hand. Soothe a local unwed mother. Grandma's hand used to ache sometimes and swell. Grandma's hand used to lift her face and tell her she'd say, baby, grandma, understand that you really love that man.
Happy birthday, grandma.
Put yourself in Jesus' hands, grandma's hand. To hand me a piece of candy, grandma's hand, pick me up each time I fail.
Have a nice
grandma's hand, boy, they really came in a handy. She'd say, Matty, don't you whip that boy.
Okay, so I was asked to make a little video, and I'm doing it with my son, Big Marcus Washington. Can you say hi, great-grandmother?
Hi, great-grandmother.
So we decided to do it together. And I think the first question was, what does my great-grandmother mean to me? And there's one word that describes her perfectly, and that one word is family. You are the matriarch of this family. And you are the true meaning of family. I see so many movies, and I see so many TV shows, and there's usually one person that brings it all together. And great-grandmother, I feel like that's you. Then one of my fondest memories, there's so many, and I played football so much, so I kind of got banged up in the head and don't remember. But for some reason, it stands out to me when you and great-grandfather came over to my parents' house to take, I think it was your anniversary pictures, I'm not sure, but you guys look so beautiful together. You brought the whole family together. I remember Alton was there, and we got to take those great pictures, and that's one of my fondest memories, just because, again, family means so much to me.
Put yourself in Jesus' hands, grandma.
We love you, great-grandmother. Happy 85th birthday, And Marcus and I are going to say it together, okay? So we're going to say happy 85th birthday on three, okay? One, two, three. Happy 85th birthday.
Each time I feel grandma's hand, boy, they really came in a handy, she'd say, Matty, don't you whip that boy. What you want to spank him for? He didn't drop no apple core, but I don't have grandma anymore. If I get to heaven, I'll look for grandma's hand.
Too, please.
Yes, thank you.
Thing. I think this is my camcorder.
Frankie, wishing you a happy 85th birthday. I love you, and I hope you have as many birthdays as possible.
This is Herb and Charlotte Evans, all the way from Dallas, Texas. We feel so blessed and privileged to be a part of your 85th birthday celebration.
You know, Charlotte, I remember the first time when we went over for their Thanksgiving dinner. They invited us and our five kids, and we all came in and smelled the food, and it was so smelling so good and inviting. And we began to go toward the table until Miss Geneva said, have you washed your hands yet? And we had all our kids and ourselves, we went straight to the restroom and washed our hands and got prepared. And thanks to Miss Geneva, we've been washing our hands ever since before our dinner.
And what an elegant woman she was then, and an elegant woman she is now. So
absolutely.
From the Evans here in Dallas, Texas, we say again,
happy birthday.
Thank you. This is Denise, and I wanted to wish you a happy 85th birthday. Congratulations, you made it to another year.
High in the air, come on everybody! Reach up, reach up, reach up, look in the air! Reach up!
Happy birthday, Grandma Futrel, have a blessed day.
Reach up, we want you to repeat it!
Happy birthday, Aunt Geneva. I don't even know where to look. This looks crazy. But I wanted to make sure that I got to be a part of your celebration and hope that you're having an amazing time. I'm so sorry that I can't be there. I'm traveling. But I think of you often and I love you. I miss you. And I look forward to seeing you really soon. Happy birthday.
And Geneva, it's Vernetta. I am Vernetta Bradley, the second daughter of May Catherine Gilner. I love you, Aunt Geneva, and I wish you a happy birthday. One thing that impresses me the most about you is your testimony. The scripture says, "Let your light so shine before men that they would see your good works and glorify your Father, which is in heaven." You have done that. Thank you so very much. The other thing that impresses me is your dignity. Everything you do in a dignified manner. Your walk, your talk, the way you dress. When I grow up, I want to be just like you. Happy birthday, Aunt Geneva.
Hi, Aunt Geneva. This is Pam, May Catherine's baby girl. Just giving a little note, shout out to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
I'm Rosen Whitaker.
And we like to say
happy birthday,
Aunt Geneva.
And many, many more.
And may the good Lord bless you all.
And the voices of a million angels could not express my gratitude. All that I am and ever hope to be, I owe it all to thee.
The one served in the aisle of this holy temple?
Yes, I hold in my hand a bag, a service of a Christian usher.
Amen.
That she was.
These three more brothers, on faithful service, I shall place them in the archives of our organization so that future generations will know that this, our departed soldier, spent a life of service in the house of my God.
Yes. Yes. Amen.
Yes.
Amen. Yes. Amen. Yes. Yes.
Birthday, Mother Geneva. I'm wishing you many more, and thank you for showing me warm love when I come to visit you at your home.
Hi, Mrs. Futrel. I just wanted to stop by to wish you a very happy birthday. I wish I could be there celebrating with you, but just know that we love you. We celebrate you today. Blessings for your 85th and many more to come. Let it be pleasing
to thee. Hey, buddy, it's Yolanda. Hello, everyone else. I am the daughter of Rito and Ruby Franklin. I am Aunt Geneva's great niece. And my mother is Ruby Gilner, and her parents are Clarence and Audrey Gilner. Aunt Geneva, I just want to wish you a happy, happy birthday. My greatest memory with you is when we went up to Spokane, Washington to see our family, Ace and Tammy Earthman. It was a great time. The road trip was wonderful. I loved learning so much from you. I love you, Auntie, and I hope you have a happy birthday.
Wherever you are, give him praise. The Bible says, let everything that hath breath praise the Lord. He's worthy.
Happy birthday, dear Aunt Geneva.
Happy birthday to you.
Cha cha
cha. Happy birthday to you.
We love you.
Happy birthday to Granny. Happy birthday to you.
I say we love you.
We love you.
Bye.
Woo! Happy birthday.